Welcome to Seven Pot Club. I'm Rob.
I grow hot peppers.
Today, I have a fascinating plant to discuss. Myrtle Spurge, also known by its Latin name, Euphorbia myrcinites. This stunning succulent is currently in full bloom right here in my front yard. However, there's more to this decorative plant than meets the eye. In my research, I stumbled upon an intriguing chemical connection between Myrtle Spurge and hot peppers. Stick around as we dive deeper into this accidental discovery. Myrtle Spurge, also known as donkey tail spurge, belongs to the diverse Euphorbia family, which includes not only succulents, but also the beloved Christmas favorite, poinsettia. Native to Eastern Europe and Western Asia, it's found its way to the United States as an ornamental plant, including my very own front yard. Let's take a closer look at the plant itself. Myrtle spurge is a low-growing succulent with stems that branch out around a foot from the base and gracefully rise up at the ends. Its distinctive blue-gray pointed leaves spiral around the stems, creating a captivating visual display. But its real beauty comes alive in the spring when it develops delicate greenish-yellow flowers. While myrtle spurge is undoubtedly eye-catching, it's essential to recognize its potential impact on the environment. This plant has a remarkable ability to rapidly spread by projecting its seeds up to 15 feet around the parent plant. Due to its aggressive nature, it's considered an invasive noxious weed in many Western states. However, in this contained urban setting, we ensure that any new shoots found outside of our designated area are promptly uprooted. Interestingly, it's not listed as an invasive species here in Minnesota. Now, let's uncover the interesting chemical connection between myrtle spurge and hot peppers. As you may know, capsaicin is the active ingredient in chilies responsible for that intense burning sensation. But did you know that some members of the Euphorbia family produce a chemical compound that can also activate the same receptors as hot peppers? This compound is called resiniferatoxin, or RTX for short. In fact, pure RTX is about 1,000 times hotter than pure capsaicin. Let's cut open a stem and see what's inside. The milky sap of myrtle spurge contains concentrated amounts of RTX. But beware, because you don't want to touch this sap with bare skin. Even a tiny amount can cause serious burns and rashes. If it comes into contact with your eyes, it can even cause blindness. And while the exterior surfaces of the plant may generally be safe to touch, it should always be handled with gloves, just in case. If you do get any sap on your skin, you need to immediately and thoroughly wash the affected area with soap and water. You can't be too careful around this toxic sap. Ask me how I know. But can you use myrtle spurge to make the world's hottest sauce? Afraid not. Ingesting resiniferatoxin can lead to intense nausea, vomiting, and diarrhea. If that's not enough, RTX is also considered to be carcinogenic. Let me make it crystal clear that no part of the myrtle spurge plant is edible. Although you can't eat it, there are potential medical uses of resiniferatoxin. RTX's nerve desensitizing properties have attracted the attention of researchers as it selectively and irreversibly destroys the neurons transmitting chronic pain sensation. Research is ongoing, and at least one company is working towards utilizing this compound to provide pain relief for late-stage cancer patients. So, despite its dangers, RTX may hold promise in the field of medicine. But I must admit that I'm scratching my head over how a compound deemed carcinogenic can also be a good treatment for cancer patients. This patch of myrtle spurge has been growing here for 12 years without incident. It's a very unique looking plant and attracts a lot of attention. But knowing its invasive and toxic nature, I find myself wondering whether I should uproot it entirely. What do you think? Let me know in the comments. As always, I appreciate your input and suggestions, and I especially appreciate viewers who like, subscribe, and smash the bell for notifications. Hope you enjoyed this exploration of a beautiful yet dangerous succulent. Until next time, keep cultivating your passion for plants. For Seven Pot Club, I'm Rob.